This is how to loom knit a Christmas stocking or cabled booty, and this is what it looks like. You can do this as a actual booty, or you can do it as a stocking. I'm using worsted yarn that's double stranded, and I'm going to be using the 24 peg loom. I'm going to show you how to do a simple one and how to do a cabled one. So what we want to do is you want to draw string cast on 24 pegs, and you're going to be working circularly. As I said, this would also be a great just straight out booty if you want to make it into it. I'll tell you how. Next, you want to e-wrap 24. Okay, at this point, you're going to, if you're doing a simple stocking, you want to go ahead and you want to e-wrap a total of 15 rows, 24 pegs, 15 rows, all the way around. You want to pause the video to complete those. If you're doing the cabled, if you're wanting to do the cable, you're going to be dividing the loom in half. This is how you're going to keep up with it. Okay? And what you're going to do is you're going to keep up with the half, and then on each half you're going to do a cabling, the 4-peg cabling in the middle. So this is how you're going to keep up. So first things first, we're going to e-wrap 3. So go ahead and e-wrap 3. And then you're going to purl 1, and then you're going to do a left 4-peg left cable cross. And we're going to do this slow so you can see it. Skip pegs 1 and 2, and then you're going to e-wrap pegs 3 and 4 and toss the bottom loop over. Here's your first 2 skipped, and those are the ones you're going to toss over. Now this is going to be the first row of a 5-row set. So go ahead and push those down and get your stitch holder and put loop 4 on first, then loop 3, and place to the middle of the work. And you want to pick up your working yarn and you want to e-wrap the first peg and then the second. So e-wrap peg 1 and peg 2. Toss the bottom loops over. And then you're going to move the loop 2 to loop to peg 4. And peg and loop 1 to peg 3. So loop 2 to peg 4, loop 1 to peg 3. Then you want to place loop 3 onto peg 1, and loop 4 onto peg 2. So one thing to keep in mind is when you are moving your loops around, make sure your odd loops when switched stay on your odd pegs and your even loops stay on your even pegs, and that's a way of keeping up with it. I also did this very same cabling with the Santa hat. So if you've watched that one, this is the same kind of cabling. Now what I like to go in and do after I've set the cross up, I like to go in and tighten my loops so I have a really nice clean cable crossing. Now we're going to continue on and we're going to purl 1, and then you're going to e-wrap 6. But once you e-wrap 3, keep in mind that's your halfway point. So go ahead and e-wrap 6. And purl 1. And we're going to do the left cable cross again up to speed. Skip the first 2, wrap the second 2. Toss the bottom loop over. Put the fourth loop and the third loop on the stitch holder. Wrap pegs 1 and 2 in that order. Place loop 2 onto peg 4 and loop 1 onto peg 3. Loop 2, peg 4, loop 1, peg 3. Even to even, odd to odd. Now you want to place loop 3 onto peg 1. And that's where you might screw up. Just remember that it goes on to peg 1. And then that goes on to 4, goes on to peg 2. And then go ahead and tighten up your loops. And then you want to purl 1. E-wrap 3, and you've completed your first row of your 5-row set. Now, continuing on, what you want to do is E-wrap 3, purl 1, E-wrap 4, purl 1, E-wrap 6, purl 1, E-wrap 4, purl 1, E-wrap 3. And this is your second row, which you'll do it three more times after this. You're going to do it 4 times. So your cabled row is row 1, and your row 2 is also your 4 rows. So you're going to do it 4 times. You're going to do this row 4 times. And that's a 5-row set. And you'll get the feel for it, and this is what to keep in mind when you go to do the upper half of this. So go ahead and do 3 more of this row, and then you'll do the 5-row set a total of 3 times. You'll need to do it 2 more times, and I'll show you what that looks like. Go ahead and pause the video to complete your 5-row set another 2 times. And that is 4 total times with that row, and then you go back and you do that cabling. There's your row 1. That makes your 5-row set. So that's 1, and then that's to do that. 5 times if you want it for a booty, 3 times if you want it for a stocking. So this is what it should look like. Again, if you want to actually wear it as a booty, you'll need to do that cabling 5 total times rather than 3. Now, if you're doing the standard, go ahead and e-wrap 17 and then stop. And if you're doing the cabled, e-wrap 3 and purl 1. Now, this section I tried to film twice, it just wasn't happening. If it cuts too much for you, you can go to my adult booties 2 types. And it's going to be the first type because this is the heel section. And so what you want to do is, if you're having a little trouble here, just go ahead and follow the heel section in the type 1 booty. But at this point, you want to get over to peg 17 and stop. And just toss all the loops over. So if you're cabling, ear up 3, purl 1, ear up 13, and stop. Now we're going to wrap and turn, and then you're going to ear wrap 10. And this is going to be for both styles. It doesn't matter whether you're cabling or not. We're doing a heel area, and if you're used to this and you've done it a lot for socks, it should be pretty standard stuff here. Now you want to wrap and turn, and you want to do wrap and turn the next peg, and then you want to e-wrap 9. And you're going to continue this wrap and turn the next peg and e-wrap until you get just before, like that, and then you're going to wrap and turn the next peg, and you're going to do that all the way down to 6 total pegs that don't have 2 loops on them. They have only 1. Again, if this is a little too choppy for you, you can watch the How to Loom Knit Adult Booties 2 types, and it'll be the first type, and it'll be the heel. If this gets too confusing. I tried to film it, but it just wasn't happening, so I wasn't going to fight it. Okay, one more time. Now that I've gotten to my 6 pegs with 1 loop in between my wrap and turns, I'm going to e-wrap 7 total pegs. And that gets rid of the first wrap and turn peg, tossing it over. Then you're going to e-wrap 8. And you're going to add an extra wrap and turn peg every time you go back to do a row until you don't have any more. Let's go ahead and e-wrap 9. Problem with my filming on this one, I did 1 too many, and so I went back to try to refilm it. Go ahead and e-wrap 10. I went back to try to refilm it and it didn't take, and so because I got it right the second time, of course, and it didn't take. So as I said, if this is too rough to follow, just go ahead and do the video footage for the other. And then e-wrap 11. And as you can see, I had an extra one. You don't want the extra one. At this point, if you're doing the normal, regular one that isn't cabled, at this point you want to e-wrap all the way back to your starting point. You'll just completed your heel. So So go ahead and e-wrap all the way back to the beginning. And if you are doing the cable, you want to e-wrap 2, purl 1, and e-wrap 3. Now you want to start doing your 5-row pattern again, but there's what your heel looks like. So for the simple stocking, go ahead and do 15 more rows of 24, and you want to do that for 15, e-wrapping 24 pegs circularly. Now if you're doing the cable, you want to do your 5-row set again for 3 sets. You want to do it 3 times. So e-wrap 3, purl 1, left 4 peg left cable cross, and I'm just showing this for those who might need a little extra as to exactly what's going on, but if you know what I'm talking about, you can go ahead and pause the video and complete that 5-row set 3 more times. But remember, your first row of that 5-row set is your cabled, and then your 4 rows is the straight without the cabling. Go ahead and make sure to tighten your loops up after you do your cable crossing so that you have a nice, neat, beautiful cabling. Purl 1. E-wrap 6. Speed this up a little bit. Purl 1, left cable cross. It's repeating just what we did on the other side. Tighten your loops. Purl 1 and e-wrap 3, and that's your first row of your 5 set. Then for your second through fifth row, you want to e-wrap 3, purl 1, e-wrap 4, purl 1, e-wrap 6, purl 1, e-wrap 4, purl 1, e-wrap 3, and I'm going to go back and toss all my bottom loops over my e-wraps. So go ahead and pause the video and complete your rows, and we'll see what you got from there. So here's what you should have with a nice heel. And this is what your cabling should look like all the way up the side. And I've changed my color to white. And we're going to do a nice cuff area. So go ahead and e-wrap all 24 pegs for a total of 15 rows. It's kind of an easy thing to remember if you're making a stocking. It's 15 on the front, 15 on the back side of the heel, and 15 for the cuff. Go ahead and do that, and we've done that, and now we're going to fold our original loops, our original white loops. You can see it, there's a separation with the red, and we're going to put those back onto the pegs, and we're going to create a cuff. So you want to put all these loops, which are really easy to see with these color changes, you're going to just put them all back on. And then you want to toss the bottom loop over the top to prep for a cast off. Because this is the inside of the boot or stocking, and so nobody's going to be seeing it. Okay, so if you want to do this as a bootie, you'll want to do a loose cast off. If you're going to do it as a stocking, just go ahead and cast off regularly. But it depends on what you're going to use them at. If you're going to wear them, I would suggest going in and doing a loose cast off. And I'll put a link below for a tutorial that shows how to do a loose cast off. So go ahead and finish that off. And then you'll want to sew up the toe, and you're going to sew up the toe like you would a sock. So I just tighten up that cast on to a point where it's a nice clean line to sew up. So go ahead and sew that and cast off. So this is what you what it should look like. Once you do that cast off, that's your inside. And you see it has a nice cuff look on the outside, and you see that I sewed it like a normal sock so that when it folds in half, it has a nice, beautiful curved toe. So there you go, you're done. That's how you make a stocking.